wouldn't have been able to do it on our own. Because why was the most famous radio talk show host prepared to help her create that radio show? I mean, how a veterinarian can't just pull off a professional radio show. I wouldn't be able to pull it off. So it looks like it was one person changing. No, no, she already
took the risk. I was known for your radio show.
But I can give you more examples. And
you need some new connections there.
like for instance, one of the Egyptian teams, the professor in genetics. So she works with disabled children, but she doesn't call them disabled children. She calls them children with special needs. And because of the frequency of consensual marriages in the Arab world, where you have to be like first cousin, you have a lot of hereditary diseases. But in the traditional Egyptian society, the woman is blamed for having a child like this. So those women go through an enormous sense of betrayal. They have been blamed for all of good girls, and they can't help what happened, and they become stigmatized. So as a geneticist, she was working with them, and the reason why she wanted to become part of Grace was because she wanted to understand how she could become more to them, how she could help them more. So she started to create a website for them, she gave them all mobile phones so they could create their own support network. Now that group took off. She was at a certain stage just going like, whoa, look at the magic. And what they did is they started the first center for children, what they call with special needs, in the Arab world. And they had to go, and one of them had to become a politician for it. She was the mother of one of those children, and then she was, okay, fine, if I need to become a politician, if I have to kind of now become part of the political debates in my governorate, then so be that. And if I have now to kind of get into debate with policymakers so that policy can change, so be that. Now that all I call emergence. And that you cannot predict that. That all is depending on the human genius that is just happens to be there together, sitting on there. Because that woman wouldn't have been able to do it without that support group either. It's really. And this female geneticist couldn't have done it without the Grace support group. So we are all part of collectives that have, and collectives also have intentionalities. Yes.
Isn't it a question a little annoying that the paradigm was called Newtonian? Because Newton was physics and mathematics, and I'm wondering how it fits into ICT's body.
Chalmers uses those two descriptions.
Yeah, Newtonian.
And here it is about the death of pluralism.
Yeah, New Newtonian. Practice, yeah.
Well, you see, okay, how I understand it. The philosophy of science that underlines our acceptance of research methodology is still very much based on classical physics, Newtonian physics. And even when it's now new Newtonian, it's still in that frame. But we already know, and you people know that more than anybody, is that without quantum physics, you wouldn't even be able to create your ICT tools. I mean, and fortunately now a lot of neuroscientists have picked it up and say the brain is the ultimate quantum computer. So now quantum science, quantum physics, is becoming an alternative, almost foundation for a new acceptance of a different type of methodology. The interesting thing though is that the social sciences, who suffered the most from the restrictions of classical physics, you know, philosophy of science, were the last to accept what quantum physics could offer in terms of philosophy of science. The last. But of course, development research, because basically we're all practical people, we want stuff that works, we want to create better reality. We are inclined to take more risks because our sense of self is more linked to co-creating, contributing to a better world than to academic accolades. So we are a little more inclined, and that's why Patton and Chambers are amongst the thinkers that are happy to take complexity science into their, you know, methodology thing. But I would say the traditional academic disciplines, why would they? There is nothing in it for them. See what I mean? And that's probably why they're so boring.
Yes.
Many of them. Okay, anybody else with a comment, or you're not happy to say, let's...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.